What determines our intelligence? One school of thought is that, okay, maybe you're either just born with it or you either have it or you don't. Some people are smart, some people are less smart. Or maybe you can change it. And it turns out there's actually been a lot of research on this in the last few decades. And the answer is pretty clear that your intelligence can actually be changed. What we've learned, what researchers have taught us, is that our brains are actually a lot like a muscle. We know that you can grow your muscles by going into the gym and doing exercise and straining your muscles. You don't just work on things that are easy for your muscles to do. You do things that your muscles have to struggle with, that your muscles have to strain with, and then they rebuild themselves and they come back stronger. By struggling, it's a signal to your body to devote more resources to that part of the body. And we see that exact same thing with the brain. And here are just a couple of examples of it. This first one, this shows how the human brain develops in early childhood. This is a depiction of the neurons in a brain at birth. And then over as a child develops, it interacts with its environment. It tries things out. It struggles. It struggles to talk, to converse, to interact with folks, to understand the world around it. And as it struggles, you see that by age six, you have a much deeper and much stronger connectedness between the different neurons. Similarly, I can never say that word. These are depictions of this is these are the neurons of two different scenarios. This is the nerves of animals that were in unstimulating environments where they're not around other animals, they're in a bear cage. And then this is the brain of an animal that is in a stimulating environment, that is constantly being challenged, that is constantly looking at stimulating new things. And so the big takeaway from this whole area of research is you absolutely can change your intelligence, that your brain is like a muscle. The more you use it, the stronger it gets. And that the best way to grow it isn't to do things that are easy for you. That might help a little bit. But what really helps your brain is when you struggle with things. And it's actually research shows that your brain grows the most not when you get a question right, but when you get a question wrong. So at least for me, this is incredibly exciting because it lets me know that when I'm going through something and I'm facing those times of maybe a little bit of adversity or a little bit of frustration, I can feel good about the fact that those are actually the times that I am growing the most. And this isn't just something that I'm saying, nice words. Research tells us when you get something wrong, when you challenge your brain, when you review why you got it wrong, when you really process that feedback, that's when your brain grows the most. And that if you keep doing that, you're well on your way to having a stronger, more able, and I guess you could say, smarter brain.